So we're in Parashat Mishpatim. We just received the Torah. And right after getting the Torah starts all the Mishpatim, all the laws. And the entire parasha is filled with all these laws that are very physical. And one of the first thing that it says in the parasha, that if you buy a Jewish, it doesn't say they were Jewish, rather Ivri, a Hebrew slave, why would you buy a Hebrew slave? If the person stole and he got caught, and then the court found him guilty, and they tell him, okay, you have to pay back what you stole, and the damages, not only to give back what you stole, I mean, you broke the window when you came in, and you damaged the rug, and many other things. You have to compensate the person. Now, if the person says, I don't have money, okay, so we'll sell you. Go and work for a year. You'll pay your debt. So the parasha starts with Kitikne Eved Ivri. And what happens if you buy the slave, and then if he wants to stay after a while, then he can stay, and if you give him, you have to give him a wife, and all these rules. That's how the parasha starts. So the Ma'amar starts ki tikne eved ivri, perush zal, perush Rashi. What does Rashi explain about that? Eved shu ivri, a slave that is coming from the Hebrews, from the Ivrim. Now, in our terms, Jewish, but there wasn't the word Jewish then, but coming from the same place. Now it's hinting on something. Remez gamken l'shnei tzadikim. It's hinting about two tzadikim. Dehine tzich ladat biro'otenu tzadik gadol, az yadu ashu megulgal minishmat tzadik gadol. When we see a real tzadik, this is, I think, one of the first times you see in the Noam Elimelech that he says tzadik gadol. Because he's always calling, always when he says the word tzaddik, he's referring to us. Here he says, when you see a tzaddik gadol, a real tzaddik, then you know that he got reincarnated. It's a reincarnation of another huge tzaddik. Minishmat tzaddik gadol, minishama elyona. Coming from another tzaddik, but from a higher level soul. V'atzaddik hazeh yesh lo ever kansharim lo'ofef bechol ha'olamot. This real tzaddik that we're referring to has a certain, here he says an organ, ever. It's not really an ever, but not really an organ. But he says he has an organ like an eagle, that eagle has a very unique quality that an eagle can fly very, very high. It's not like a little bird that just goes around. An eagle can go high and high, and has very large wings. Very wide wings, and the way the feathers are organized, I don't know if that's the right way of saying it, but the way that he has his structure, he can go on, I don't know, again the word in Hebrew, in English, on these warm winds, and he just goes higher and higher and higher.
Current.
So he doesn't flip his wings, and he doesn't go straight up, rather he glides on the currents of winds, and is going higher and higher and higher. Needless to say, he has a very sharp vision. He can see from that those heights, a little mouse on the floor. But nevertheless, the ego has the quality of going extremely, extremely high. The same way that the ego goes extremely high, then the tzaddik has a certain mechanism. Here he calls it an ever, an organ. But nevertheless, the idea that the same way that the ego can fly high, then the tzaddik can go high in the worlds. While he's in this world, he can go higher and higher into higher worlds. We heard so many stories, whether it's the Baal Shem Tov, the Arizal, and many others, that while they were still alive in this world, they were going into higher worlds. They had the ability to do it. This is where the word Ivri comes from. Ivri milashon ever. Ivri is you can explain it as Hebrew. Avraham was called Ivri, but Ivri also resembles the word in Hebrew ever. Ever is an organ. The ayin mitchalef be'alef, because the ayin can be switched with an alef. Vehu lashon kenafaim, and this ever, this word ever, is rooted from the same place of the word in Hebrew, knafaim, wings. Vehainu, ki tikne eved ivri, muvan mimele sheyesh lo knafaim lofef. When it's referring to when you buy a slave, a eved ivri, this is referring to that, of course, that it has the so to say, that spiritual organ, that he has wings to fly higher and higher. Where do I need to fly? I need to fly in two different places. Be'ava ve'ira. I have to fly with fear of Hashem and love to Hashem. Specifically, be'olamot elunim, in higher worlds. Bechlal, we know, we explained a couple times that the love and fear that I have, it's of course love to Hashem and fear from Hashem. And this is not fear that I'm afraid that Hashem will break my bones. Rather an awe. This is called Yirat HaRomemut, that I have awe from Hashem, I have respect. This is called fear. But the Zohar says that the love and the fear are like wings. Trei Gadfin. We're in the third Ma'amar, if you want to join us. It starts, Kitikne V'divri. The Zohar says that the love and the wing are like two wings. One side is the love, one side is the fear. And when a bird wants to take off, it needs to flip both wings. It can't go with one wing. There's no such a bird that can take off with one wing. It needs both of the wings. But once the bird starts flapping the wings, then the bird can start taking off. So the love and the fear are my wings, and that helps me to take off, to go to higher worlds. Then he continues, Shesh shanim ya'avod. It says in the parasha that the slave has to work for 6 years. If he sells himself to you, then he has to work for 6 years, and on the seventh year, in the sabbatical year, he goes free. Shesh shanim ya'avod, remez leshnotav shel adam. This 6 years is hinting about the years of the human being. Dahainu, shisha asiriyot shanim tzarich la'avod. Hinting that 6/10 I need to work. Meaning 60 years, referring to. Uvashvit yetzel ha'chofshi chinam. And in the seventh year, in the sabbatical year, then the slave goes out to freedom for free. אז אין צריך עבודה בכוח. Meaning that in the 70th year, if I did my right work spiritually for 60 years, on the 70th year, in that millennium, then the work that I do, my service of Hashem, doesn't come with a struggle. Saying in other words, that I need to invest 60 years in Avodat Hashem. Avodat Hashem is the service of Hashem. Now, usually, any type of labor is hard. I mean, some people have a job that they sit on a chair all day long. That's also not an easy job, not to move yourself. But here, when it's referring to sheshanim, 6 years for the slave, it's referring to 6/10, meaning 60 years, that I have to invest 60 years in Avodat Hashem. If I do that, then the 10 years in the 70th year, then it becomes what's called bederch mimele. It will already happen by default. Az en tzarich avoda bekoach, rak shu mimele, devuk bo, itbarach. I don't have to put too much hard work into my avodat Hashem. Just by default, I will be already attached to Hashem. V'u chofshi me'yetzer hara. And I'm free from the yetzer hara. That's why it says, Ubashvi yitzeh chinam. Chinam, chinam is free. So after 60 years of hard work serving Hashem, when I go into the 70th year, then I'm free from the yetzer hara. Umikol gashmei olam hazeh. Not only that I'm free from the yetzer hara, rather from all the gashmiut, the physicality of this world. Doesn't affect me. Now we continue. It says, Im begapo yavo, begapo yitzeh. If he comes in with a full, like a healthy body, he has to live with a healthy body. Here it's referring to Perush, im baknafay megulgal minishmat tzadik, begapo yetze. If the tzadik is getting reincarnated in the wings of the previous tzaddik, meaning to take him to a higher level. Which means, saying in other words, that if I come back in this world with the wings of a tzaddik, so to say, to take me up to a higher level, then I'm going to be able to elevate myself in the worlds of Kedusha, so I can come to a much higher world. Now he continues, Im ba'al ishahu, this is what the verse says, if he has a wife, a woman, Deita bazor, it says in the Zohar, in the holy book of Zohar, the guf adam ha-mesayol la'avodat Hashem itbarach, hu yakum imo l'tchiyat ha-metim. The Zohar says that the body that allows me to serve Hashem, this body is allowing me to serve Hashem. I mean, the body doesn't need a mitzvah, it's the soul that needs to do the mitzvah. But the body allows the soul to do the mitzvah. This body that assisted the soul to do a mitzvah will be resurrected in the resurrection of the dead very soon, in Techiyat Hameitim. Lefamim yesh la neshama achat harbe gufim. But what happens when I have many bodies? If I'm here already 10 times, then I have 10 bodies, one soul, 10 bodies. What am I going to do there? Which body is going to come up in the Techiyat Hameitim? That's a deep question that many people ask. Okay, I do believe in Techiyat Hameitim. Very soon Mashiach is coming. We're going to have Techiyat Hameitim. This is the resurrection of the dead. Now, what happens if I'm here already 10 times? I don't know. Maybe I'm here already 100 times. I don't know how many times I'm here. But it can be thousands, yeah? But which body is going to be the body that comes in Techiyat Hameitim? Lifamim yesh lo neshama achat harbe gufim. One soul has many bodies. Shebat ha-begilgul kama pe'amim. That comes in a reincarnation a couple times. Ve'en kol ha-gufim omdim le-tchiyat ha-metim. Not all the bodies will stand in Techiyat Hameitim. Rak ha-guf shayam mesayo la-avodoto itbarach. Only the body that actually assisted you to serve Hashem. Because if I came here 100 years ago, 200 years ago, whatever it is, but the body didn't assist me to serve Hashem, that body is not going to get up. Only the body that assisted me to do Avodat Hashem. Now, this is off the subject, but since we already brought it up, the Rizal explains in the book that is called Gates of Reincarnation. Now, what happens if I had 5 bodies that helped me to do a mitzvah? Which one? First of all, it's going to be the body that is most refined. But the Rizal explains, this you can find in chapter 3 and 4 in Gates of Reincarnation. We're learning this every Tuesday. That, I know it sounds a little bit like Frankenstein, but body parts will be attached. So if in a previous reincarnation a certain body part was assisting to a mitzvah, that part of the body will be attached to one big body that will get resurrected. So it's not that we're going to get up with all these stitches here like Frankenstein. But, and again, it's not that the grave is going to open and bodies are going to start coming out. It's a much more refined world. It's not that we're going to be walking out of cemeteries like this. It's a little bit more higher level of a being. But nevertheless, the parts of the body, I mean, if you remember, we started learning now in Sha'arei Kedusha that there is a physical body, and there's also a spiritual body besides the soul. The souls get dressed into a spiritual body that gets dressed into the physical body. So it's a little bit more complicated. Like I said, it's not our subject right now. You can find it in the Gates of Reincarnation. The Rizal explains about it a lot. But just to feed our curiosity, first of all, the only body parts of the body that were assisting in doing a mitzvah. More than that, then their different parts will be connected together and it will form one big healthy body. With that said, now we continue when it says, if a person has a wife, I mean, we're talking here about the slave. If the person has a wife, what does that mean? Zehu im ba'al ishahu, remez laguf shetiken gufo la'avod la'shem itbarach. When the Torah says if he has a wife, it's referring here to the slave, but it's a hint to the body that refined, that the body got refined, specifically serving Hashem. I'll give you an example. Many years ago, this hand was used to steal. And now this hand is used to put tefillin on. So you take the same hand, the same body, that this hand used to take money that doesn't belong to him, or whatever type of stealing. Now it changed its purpose. Now the hand is putting tefillin on. And this eye right here was used to do X, and now the eye is used to read Torah. And like this, you can go one organ after the other. And you can transform the body, and literally you can do it with everything. One time these teeth used to chew unkosher meat. Now the teeth are chewing kosher meat. And one time this tongue used to curse and say Lashon Hara. Now the tongue is praising Hashem. So when it says about in the parasha, if the person is has a wife, then it's hinting. Everything here, we're learning here now what the Noam Elimelech is really going into the more of a deeper level of explaining the parasha, that is called more like a remez. If you remember, we learned many times that the Torah can be explained in four levels: Pshat, Remez, Drash, and Zod. And Remez is a hint. It's a hinting on something. So when the Torah is saying that if the servant, the slave has a wife, it's referring to the body that refined the body that has a body. The soul is the husband and the body is the wife. And the body has refined itself to serving Hashem. La'avod Hashem itbarach. Ve'yatzah ishto imo. What does the verse says in the Torah? That if the slave came into the slavery with a wife, then the wife also goes out to freedom after 7 years. Now, just reading the parasha, it's important that you read the parasha when we're learning this so we know what he's talking about. It says that if I have a slave, I have the obligation of giving him a wife. I can't tell him, listen, you can't have a wife. Now if I give him a wife, then the wife becomes also a slave. And then if they have a child, the child is also a slave. Now, excuse me, after 6 years, the slave can leave. But if he says, no, I'm happy here. I have a good job, I have a wife, I have a nice house, I want to stay. That's what we read now in the parasha, that the master takes him to the doorpost and pierces his ear. So he makes him a slave, or he takes him to the Beit Din. But nevertheless, it says if the person has a wife, then the wife goes out with him. Since we said the wife is referring to the body that was refined to Avodat Hashem, then when he leaves, Ishto Imo, his wife lives with him. Meaning to say, רוצה לומר, שגם הגוף ייהנה עם הנשמה. Meaning that if I use this body right now to serve Hashem, and the body is taking me 400 steps down to the Ari, the mikveh of the Ari, the body needs to get a reward here. And my body is the one who walked me to the synagogue, and my mouth helped me learn, and my eyes and my ears and my brain and my legs, and my body is participating here in Avodat Hashem. The body needs to get a reward. And the body gets a reward in Techiyat Hameitim. And that means that the body will have some type of pleasure that the soul gets. Now originally, Adam HaRishon and Chava, they didn't have bodies in the beginning. They were just souls. Later on, they became more physical and they got bodies. So when we're going to reach to the point of Techiyat Hameitim, this is a very high level that we're going to go back to the state of how Adam and Chava were. There were souls in bodies. So they had the ability of a soul, even though it was still in a limited body. And that's, right now we don't have that. Right now the body is in control and the soul is second. Very soon when Mashiach is going to come, we're going to experience the connection between the body and the soul. So the soul is going to be operating in a very high spiritual level, but the body is going to be taken with it. So here we find a very interesting hint in the beginning of the parasha. We refer to this parasha as a very physical thing. You know, there are three types of mitzvot. The first one is called Mishpatim. The other one is called Edut. And the third one is called Chok, Chukim. These are the three types. Mishpatim are all the mitzvot that are very easy to understand, that I can understand it with my common sense. Edut is testimony. These are the mitzvot that are testifying for something that happened. like Hanukkah, Purim, Pesach. Pesach is a testimony that we left Mitzrayim. Shabbat is a testimony for the creation of the world. These are called Edut. And the last one is called the Chok. Chok is a law. Something that doesn't make sense. Mikveh. Or red heifer. Or now in this end of this parasha, we're learning about meat and dairy. Lo tevashel gdi b'chalev imo. That's a chok. I don't understand. What's the common sense between the meat and the dairy? Why am I allowed to cook many other things, but specifically meat and dairy I can't? This falls under the category of chok. So the whole parasha here is talking about laws that are called mishpatim. Very simple things. It's talking here about in this parasha about nezikim. You know, you did a damage to me, you have to pay me. And mamonot, and all sorts of laws of finance and money. You worked for me, I have to pay you. You didn't pay me, I can sue you. These are all called mishpatim. But nevertheless, even in the physical law that we find in the Torah, now we're going to start going into these parashot that are more analytical, they're more law. And some might find them very boring parashot. It's not exciting, you know, drama, Yosef and the brothers, and action, and there's going to be laws, very dry laws. And most people find these parashot very boring. Comes the Noam Elimelech and says, don't look at the surface. On the surface, it will be pretty boring. You think I care about an Eved Ivri, about a slave, and he comes in with a wife, without a wife, goes in with the child, without, who cares about that? We don't have slaves there now. But the Noam Elimelech comes and says, don't look at the surface. Look one level beneath the surface and just start explaining and interpreting what we just said. So the Eved is referring to us. I'm Eved Hashem. I have to serve Hashem. And when it says Eved Ivri, Ivri is hinting on the word Ever. Ever is a limb, an organ. And it's referring to the wings that the tzaddik has, like an eagle. An eagle has wings because the eagle can go very, very high. Then the tzaddik also uses his wings to go higher and higher in spiritual worlds. So I also have these wings. These are called love and fear. The Zohar calls it trei gadfin, two wings. If I use my love and fear to Hashem, then I'm, so to say, I'm growing and growing and I'm ascending to higher worlds. Then it says that if I invest 6 years, 6 years is the slave we're talking here, sheshanim yavod, 6 years he has to work, it means that I have to serve Hashem 60 years. Now this is not pension, that I go to pension after 60 years. But I have to, the 6 years is referring to six decades, meaning 60 years. If I serve Hashem with love and fear for 6 decades, then on the 7th decade, I go out for free. No yetzirah. I don't have to serve Hashem. I am still serving Hashem, but there's no yetzirah anymore. And there's no a struggle. Then, of course, it's referring to that if I come into this deal with the wife, and the wife is my body, because really it's my soul that needs to serve Hashem, and not my body. But I can't neglect the body. The body is part of the system. I can't just sit and feed the neshama all day long. The body also has to be fed. The body also has to be nourished here. So he's teaching us a very interesting thing, that I have to understand that when I come down to this world, I am Eved Hashem. I'm the slave of the Kadosh Baruch Hu. That's what one of the deals that we took on ourselves in Matan Torah. That Hashem says, I want you to be my slaves. Are you accepting? Because if you look at the first commandment that we just read yesterday, it says, Anochi Avai Elokecha, I am your God. And interestingly, it says it in a single tense, Elokecha. It doesn't say Elokechem. Elokecha is your God, single tense. And if it would be talking to all of us, it would be Elokechem, your gods. We talked about it yesterday, that all the people who were standing in Matan Torah, when they woke up from the vision, they were like, whoa, don't ask. God talked to me. So his fellow friend told him, no, you have a mistake. He talked to me. No, he talked to me. They all heard it like it was a personal conversation. Why? Because Hashem says, Anochi Avai Elokecha, your God. But what does it say right after? You would expect Hashem to say, I am your God who created the world, or who created a man. It says asher hotzeticha me'eretz Mitzrayim, that I took you out of Egypt. Why are you telling me out of Egypt? It doesn't seem like such a big miracle. Tell me you took me out of Egypt, you created the world. And I'm your God that created the world. But Hashem says, asher hotzeticha me'eretz Mitzrayim, mibet avadim. You were a slave to Paro, and I took you out of slavery from Paro. He wasn't a good boss. He was slaving you. But you have a choice. You either want to be a slave to Paro, or you want to be a slave to me. You choose. If you choose to be a slave to Paro, then fine. And that's why 80% of the nation died in Mitzrayim. Because they said, I don't want to be a slave to you, God. I want to be a slave to Paro. I'm fine with here. I'm fine with having an iPhone and being stuck in the physical world. And that's what I want. That's why 80% didn't go out. Not because they were idol worshippers or they were sinning. Because they didn't say, they said, I don't want you to be my God. I don't see any benefit with you being my God. I'd rather be a slave to Paro. And we're slaves also to Paro. Paro is a klipa. Paro is a klipa of physicality. I choose if I want to be a slave to Hashem or a slave to Paro. So, slave to Hashem or slave to Paro. So here it's referring to two. You are a slave. You have to understand that you are a slave. You have to wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning. And you have to go and praise Hashem and thank Hashem and worship Hashem. So the only difference is that Hashem is the best boss. There's no other boss like Him. He gives you everything that you need. Pays you on time, vacation, everything that you want, Hashem gives you. Big, put yourself on Hashem's payroll, you'll see that there's no better boss than Him. It's an honor to be a slave to the Master of the Universe. You just have to make the decision to who you want to be a slave to. You want to be a slave to the boss, and trust me, you'll get everything that you need. I can vow for that. Hashem is the best boss. You're not going to find any other boss better than Him. Or you choose to be a slave to the world, to your job, to your phone, to your car, whatever it is, and you decide. The only thing that we have to remember is that here we have two components. I have my body and I have my soul. And if my body is not participating, my soul will not go higher. That's why specifically it says Eved Ivri, referring to my wings. My soul has the ability of ascending, but if my body doesn't allow the soul to grow, then I'm going to be stuck in the same place. I need to just understand how am I making the right combination. And the thing is that the body is lazy. You wake up in the morning, the body tells you, I want to sleep. You want to eat, the body says, let's eat that greasy food. It's very delicious. It's going to feel very tasty on my taste buds. So the body just wants pleasure. You just need to know how to explain to the body that the real pleasure it's going to get in the time of resurrection of the dead. That's why it says, if he has a wife, then she has to go free with him. If the body assists the soul, then the body will receive pleasure at the time of Techiyat Hameitim. If the body doesn't assist the soul, then it's not going to get anything. It's just going to become worm food. So we just have to make a quick decision right now how we're applying our life. And the right choice is to be a slave to Hashem. I know it doesn't sound so great. Well, I'm a slave. I don't be a slave. But yeah, we are slaves. Avadim ha'item. We are slaves to the Kadosh Baruch Hu, but trust me, it's the best boss to be a slave to. Mezrat Hashem, we should learn from that our entire avodah, our entire work has to be directed only to the Kadosh Baruch Hu, and the ultimate reward is only coming from the Kadosh Baruch Hu. And needless to say, the only spiritual growth that I get is if the body is involved in my avodat Hashem. That's why you see in the Jewish religion versus many other religion, our religion requires a lot of work. Other religion says just believe or meditate or whatever. We are the only religion that comes with so many mitzvot, so much work, because the body has to be involved here, and if the body is not involved, then the soul cannot take off, because the soul is connected to the body. Zad Hashem, this should inspire us to get closer to Hashem, do a lot more mitzvot. Needless to say, that's how we ascend to a much higher place. And needless to say, that's how we reach to Techiyat Hameitim very soon. Rabbi Chananiah ben Kasher omer, Ratzah Kadosh Baruch Hu zakot et Yisrael, Lefichach hirba lehem Torah ומצוות שנאמר, Adonai chafetz eman tzidko, Yagdil Torah ויאדיר.